If you have an old home theater system like me, then you have found a very popular connectivity option called Bluetooth is missing on your system. Without this facility, you have to face the wear mess of normal aux connection. And of course, if you are thinking to buy a new home theater system, then it can easily cost you around $20 to $25. And it is important to say that this is the minimum price you have to pay. According to the models, sound quality and facilities, the price may go upwards, obviously. So today in this video, I am going to show you how you can convert your old non-Bluetooth sound system into Bluetooth one. So let's get started. I think you are already familiar with my home theater system. I have repaired it couple of videos ago. Now I am thinking to convert it into Bluetooth home theater system. There is plenty of Bluetooth modules out there who can easily help me in this project. But the question is which one? I have picked this rather cheap one, cost me around 99 Indian rupees. Now the question is, how do I connect this module with my home theater? Very simple, just take a 5 volt power adapter and connect the module with it. Now take a 3.5 mm to RCA cable. Connect the 3.5 mm jack to the module and the RCA jacks to the home theater system and power them up. Now it's time to pair the module with the music source like a smartphone or laptop, etc. Now as you can see, everything is working just fine. I can enjoy all of my favorite songs on this Bluetooth sound system. But in my opinion, at just looking at the cable mess, I think this is not a very efficient or effective way to make a Bluetooth home theater system. Maybe this process is good for a beginner, but as an enthusiast, I will never like it. So to remove the cable mess and this unprofessional work, I have thought how it will be if I integrate the module inside this box. I think it's a very good idea, right? To apply my thoughts in reality, I have unscrewed all of these 8 screws and opened the enclosure. After that, I have identified the wire sets who are responsible for the audio input. As I have said, I want to set the module inside the box, so we have to need a power source also. In the beginning, I used a simple circuit board which consists with a couple of common components like 4007 diodes, 220 microfarad capacitor, 5 volt regulator IC like 7805 and the USB female connector. Basically, this board converts 14 volt AC to 5 volt DC. I want to use the inbuilt transformer of the home theater system to power the Bluetooth module. Now I am connecting my new power conversion circuit with the transformer. After connecting the 3.5 mm jack of home theater to the Bluetooth receiver, I have connected the receiver to the USB port. After powering them up, as you can see, a pretty bad and annoying sound is produced by my home theater. It is due to common grounding of Bluetooth receiver and the circuitry of the home theater system. To solve this problem, I am using a 5 volt power adapter. After removing the main circuitry of the power adapter, I have immediately soldered 4 different wires into it. 2 of them is for AC input and the others will be connected to a USB female connector from where our Bluetooth receiver takes the power. Now the common grounding problem is solved, because both Bluetooth receiver and the home theater circuit have different power sources. Before doing anything, I have disconnected the important wires of the circuit board which are connected to the component of this MDF board. And lastly, I have disconnected this black wire which is used for the antenna connections. Yes, this sound box or home theater, whatever you call it, has an integrated FM radio. Anyway, I have unscrewed these screws of the circuit board and lift it from its prison, but I have not disconnected these connectors right now. Now let's set the 5 volt power adapter circuit with a bit of hot glue. It is also mentionable that I have to use a 3PDT switch, which is used to change the input sources of the home theater. But the problem is that I haven't found any 3PDT switch on my local market. So I have used 2 different switches. One is a simple SPST switch and the other one is the DPDT switch. If the both switches are set upward, then the sound system takes the audio input from Bluetooth source. If these switches are set downwards, then the input line is this AB jacks. Very simple, right? To set these switches, I have drawn a straight line with the help of combination square ruler. After that, I have drilled two holes with a 5mm drill bit. To enlarge the holes, I then have re-drilled those holes with a 5.5mm and then 6mm drill bit. After this messy drilling process, I then have cut grooves for the switches with the help of a flat drill bit. When I am happy with the results, I have placed those switches and tightened their nuts. Now it's time for the connections. First of all, I have just soldered 6 extension wires with the switches. Then I have cut one end of the aux cable and soldered the naked wires with the free terminals of the switch. Okay, let's talk about the connections. First of all, I have cut this connector from this wire and then I have connected it to the switch according to this diagram. These wires are actually input line of the home theater. Anyway, the remaining wires of the switch go to this small circuit board where the input output RCA jacks are soldered. Okay. It's time to discuss about the power supply of the Bluetooth receiver. I have set a small switch mode power supply inside the housing, which I have talked about earlier. This time, I am connecting a USB female type A connector with the output of the power supply, because I don't want to connect the power supply wires directly into the Bluetooth receiver internally. It makes a lot of chance to destroy it completely. Okay, the upgradation is completed. Now I have set the main home theater circuit board in place and tight all the nuts to set it properly. Then connect the important connectors to their own place. After that, I am connecting the receiver to the USB port. Now it's time to connect the other end of the aux cable with it. Next, I am setting up the small power supply with the 220 volt power line where the main transformer of the home theater is connected. Thus, the project is almost completed. As a final touch, I have used a bit of hot glue to set the whole receiver assembly with the body of the home theater. And please don't forget to cover the naked wire joints with the insulators or heatsink tube. They protect the circuit from the unexpected short circuits. Okay, everything is done. After putting the lid on its own place, I have tightened all the 8 screws which I have opened earlier. Now it's time for the testing. After pairing my phone with the Bluetooth module, I can easily enjoy my favorite playlist from this sound system. And of course, don't forget to turn the two-way switches on this side. Lastly, I have marked which position of the switch is used for which, Bluetooth or wired connection. So converting a simple wired home theater into a wireless one is successful. And the sound quality is pretty awesome, just like wired connection. No distortion and nothing. Hope you guys enjoy by watching this video. If so, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe and turn on the notification bell for the future updates. Thank you so much. So these are my final terms of every videos, but this video is somehow music related. So enjoy the music.